Welcome back to Let's Play Scratches, Director's Cut. Speaking of scratchy, my voice is scratchy. Anyway, we just finished exploring this room, reading a very long journal over there. How do we get over here to the door? We have to go this way? And that way. Okay. My apologies for the janky controls. It likes to stick at the ends of the screen here. It was just some useless junk. Elegant and tasteful. What are you doing with those, sir? The place was full of exquisite, albeit aged, candelabras. And pictures. Just in case I tried again, but still there was no power. What are we doing here? Looks like they're making him stick his finger into a wound in the guy. But there's no blood. That's a weird picture there. Oh, we got here. I couldn't decide what was more impressive, the incredible collection of books in the study or the amount of booze in the dining room. A couple of beautiful vases made of shiny glass were standing on the table. Indeed they were. I guess that's what happens when you don't water the plants for a very long time. I was kind of aiming at the window. This stuff, right? Or maybe not. No, I did. I looked at eat. Alright, so there's not much going on in here. There's another door. Well, that way and that way. I think this connects with where we were. So let me just... I think we've been to the room on the other side of this. Oh, we've actually been here. Right, here's the staircase. Alright, so let's try this other door then. Stairs up. Whoop. Several vases of African craftsmanship were standing against the west window. It was just an ordinary vase. I couldn't see any reason to bother with it. Huh. Handmaiden's Tale. I think I've seen this painting before. Like in real life, I mean. All of a sudden it's so quiet. A generic standard lamp, still, it was elegant and tasteful. Well, I would think they were hanging him, but it's tied around his waist. The rope. These people are working the field. Yeah, I don't know what's going on with him. The drawer was stuck beyond hope. Beyond hope, I tell you. What the meaning of these, some of these paintings are. They're eating. What? What is that? Fruit? Like, is he holding it by the rind, kind of? Grapes there? Yeah. Can't have a seat. Sit down here. Okay. I'm hesitant to go upstairs for some reason. Looks rather dirty in here. A key holder, except there weren't any keys hanging from it. It was just an ordinary little table underneath the key holder. What about this stuff over here? There were plenty of kitchen utensils in the house, ready to be used. Funny, I think of utensils as like knives and forks, spoons, not pots and tea kettles. The door to the oven was firmly stuck in place. Can I open that? Stop moving! Is that something? They look like doors that can be opened. Huh. Okay, stop. It gets stuck at the edge of the screen. Apparently the water wasn't running. Oh, brother. Bones? The interior of the refrigerator was begging for some serious cleaning, not to mention a powerful disinfectant. What's that? Oh, grinder? The grinder was open and waiting for anything to be tossed inside to test its blades. Ooh, boy. It was a nice, rustic, old-fashioned grinder. Well, so foreboding. Well, if we need to grind anything, here we are. Can I look at these items? How do I get over there? There were plenty of kitchen utensils in the house, ready to be used. These don't open. Alright. I want to go over there. Or here. Countless jars and cans adorn the kitchen. Oh, sugar, sugar. Flour, tea. Lots of flour, tea, and sugar. The door to what I assumed was the basement was locked. Yeah, I don't think I want to go in there just yet. Or at all, probably. Oh, stop. It won't stop. I hate that. Oh. Can't look at that. Scratches on the wall. Scratches. Oh, whose room is this? It's quite a sad bed, isn't it? A photo of the woods outside, possibly? Oh, squirrel. The topmost sheet of paper of the pile had some curious markings on it, so I grabbed it to have a closer look. You did? Did we take it? Oh. It was a piece of paper with some strange markings, and I was sure there was much more to it than it first seemed clear. Huh. I can't see the markings. Housekeeping. Old something. Sound like we wrote something down. Just a bunch of uninteresting books. Outside, I guess. Is that the chapel? It looked like whoever stayed in this room loved photography. I mean, I'm sure this is, yeah, for making exposures and such. It was just some useless junk. How do I close this back up again? Empty. I don't have the indicator here telling me how or when to close this stuff. So I got the down arrow here. It's not appearing. Wait, on. Oh, on that. Never mind. Practical photography, class and paper, a manual, something simple directions for this production of portraits, views, etc. by the agency of light. Something. Collodion, aluminum, calotype, wax paper, and positive paper processes. A paper on the method of taking stereoscopic pictures. By Charles A. Long, 2nd edition, London, published by Bland and Long Opticians, Photographical Instrument Makers, and Opera-like Chemists? 158 Fleet Street, entered at Stationer's Hall, 1956. The bed in this room was miserable looking, indeed. It's the first thing I thought. I don't suppose anything under the bed? Okay. Bathroom? Oh, this is where his little dark room, I guess. Well, how would he even... I guess not. Because I don't see any easy way to cover the windows here. The outside of the, mansion. What? Those actual people sitting there, yeah, I guess. It's funny because they look like cutouts. Just the chapel outside. I think. The fountain outside. The sink was covered with a thick coating of dust. It looked as if the cleaning ladies had skipped this room. The smell coming from the toilet prevented any further investigation. Yeah, I'll bet. Oh, he's developing his photos in here. But then where do you black out the windows? There's not even any curtains on them. Well, this is a photo of the kitchen right outside. Two rooms back. Oh, I've seen these. didn't look at this mirror. I can't see myself in the mirror. I'm a vampire. Whoops. Don't get stuck again. Don't get stuck. No. Down. I miss this. The knife! I got the knife! Oh my god. I didn't think I could get that. I was carefully holding a sharp butcher's knife. Now. Oh. Can we get here from the front? Because I didn't spot this. Can't go any further, huh? I see something change over here with the cursor. Oh, we can't go further this way. We've been here, right? A thick wire was tied between both handles, securing the door to the crypt. No, we haven't been here. So that was... that photo was of the crypt. Not the chapel. Let me take another look at it. Yep, definitely. What if we take the butcher's knife and cut the cape? I really don't want to go in the crypt. If I don't have to. I'm sure we have to at some point. Alright, so... it was impossible to cut the wire with the knife. Oops. That wasn't useful. Years of corrosion had stiffened the wire on the door handles, making it impossible to manipulate with my bare hands. It's funny. Wired shut is more useful to keeping something in than keeping something out, isn't it? So from here we can only go that way, right? Yeah. And from here we can only go inside or back. So, I'm going to make sure I've exhausted all possibilities before going up any stairs. This is a dead end of a sort. That goes back to the library. It goes back there. That's what the dead tree or whatever. Whoops. Okay. So I'm gonna save and let's go upstairs. And look at this chandelier here. Okay, stop. I remember that Jerry said a nice room had been prepared for me upstairs. Oh boy. Oh, that just goes down. I thought I could look at the window or out the window. Surprised we can't look at the chandelier at all. My luggage was feeling heavier by the minute. Alright, so we do have a door here. And at least three other doors. Quickly realized this had to be my room. It became evident why as I glimpsed the gorgeous view through the huge window. Very nice. Must try all light switches. We're a vampire. Okay. They're a little pale. The books in the room are rather boring. No horror novels. Unbelievable. Huh. Why is it that I can't concentrate? Crumpling pages like this. I'm getting worse. The whisperings. They're killing me. They cannot be real. They cannot be real. barred the doorway but still can hear them in my dreams. How to get rid of it? If it was only that simple, but tearing it apart would force me to admit its otherworldly nature. No, it just can't be possible. I can't allow these thoughts to cross my mind. But I can really hear them, so clearly. Have I really lost it? It just can't be that I'm experiencing exactly what James did. It has to be influence. How else to explain that every time I walk past the gallery, the whispers grow louder? They're luring me inside. It wants me closer. I can hear them again. Yes, the tortured souls of the fallen, now suffering for eternity. A chant. Next room. What says next room? I know for sure its source now. I can't fool myself any longer. Are those drums? Oh, please, for Christ's sake, don't let it be drums. I have to document this. I have to keep going, because if James was right, may God have mercy on our souls. Barred the doorway. I wondered what had distressed the writer this much. Something tells me we're soon to find out. The ideal place to put my luggage was, of course, my room. Yeah, I'd say so. A beautiful oak desk was standing against a window with an extraordinary and inspiring view. The view was inspiring. Jerry had picked the right room for me. It would be ideal when doing some work. Trying to look at these, like, hourglasses and inkwells and stuff. That little table could come in handy. I didn't like the idea of carrying around my luggage. He really wants me to put down the luggage. I will. Someone's sick here. I thought I could open this or something. Okay. It was too early to go to bed. My luggage was killing me. It really wants me to put this down. You died. Your luggage killed you. Load a previous save. State Board of Medical Examiners of Rothberg. Christopher Edward. It appeared as if a doctor used to sleep in this room. Holton? Hilton? I can't read that. Medicine and Surgery. Nothing to look at here, huh? Baby born here. Oh. Clinical maternal. Really? That's a skull with horns in someone's stomach. Like a cattle skull, almost. What the hell? I grabbed the stethoscope, which seemed to be about the only useful thing in the bag. So we have a stethoscope here. My luggage is feeling heavier by the minute. Alright, I'll put it down. Hold on a second. It was a fancy stethoscope. Alright, what do you want me to put it on the bed? Okay, is this the luggage? One holds the typewriter, I think. That wasn't a proper place to leave the case. That rhymes. You want me to put it on the desk? There's plenty of room for it here. The desk wasn't an appropriate place to put the luggage. I wanted to take advantage of the view. Alright. On this, then? Where do you want me to put it? There we go. I find a good spot to leave my luggage. I thought it'd be better to leave my typewriter and stuff ready. Oh. Oh, you want me to take it out and stuff, okay.